Hey everybody, it's Justice for Comics. I had to reshoot that video, my last video, because I guess the audio went out almost near the end. I forgot to set my phone up for Do Not Disturb. So if I get a phone call or something like that, it just clicks off the audio. It's kind of a pain. So hopefully we don't have any issues with this video. So some of this might be a little bit of a repeat. So if you already watched the first video that I deleted, and go ahead and skip, you know, you can probably skip through this. So a little bit of comic book news. Obviously, we're talking about Star Wars. Gina Carano got let go from Disney about a week ago, last week. And looks like Hasbro is discontinuing her Star Wars figures, which of course makes the ones that they did produce go up in value. I looked on eBay, a couple of her figures are going between $150 to $275. So yeah, there's too bad we don't have any Toys R Us's anymore. They always had a tons of Star Wars figures. Trying to think like where, you know, obviously most people buy stuff online now, but at least near me, I don't think there's any real toy stores. I think Barnes & Noble still sells toys. That's, I guess if you run across one of her action figures, you may want to pick it up, throw it on eBay, make maybe 10 times your money. Seems like a pretty good a flip opportunity right now. So Gina Carano is landing on her feet. She just got it off. She got offered a deal from Daily Wire to produce and star in her own movie. So she is gainfully employed. Daily Wire, I think Ben Shapiro is involved. He's a conservative Jewish man who was not offended by her comments. Some Jewish people were, some aren't. I don't think her comments were all that inflammatory, I don't think it also justified getting rid of her. But you know, that's the thing with working for somebody. They can decide at any moment, we don't want you working here anymore. So, that's freedom. That's the freedom to have who you want to work for you. And of course, Disney is getting some blowback from some fans. A couple days ago, I think the hottest trending Twitter hashtag was hashtag cancel Disney Plus. So, you know, that's happening. And it's, from what I understand, I was watching one of the YouTube videos this morning. Mike Zero, who's a big Star Wars YouTuber, he's got 270,000 subscribers. Obviously, he's got an insider within Lucasfilm, and he was saying that basically George Lucas is not happy with how Disney handled things. She was basically fired over social media. They didn't have her come in and speak to her in person or even have a conversation over the phone with her. They just basically told her over social media that she's fired. Kind of a dick move by Disney. Disney's this big machine. I said it a long time ago when the news announcement came out that Star Wars was being purchased by Disney. I really thought that was a bad idea for Star Wars fans. Although you were going to get movies and, you know, Lucas obviously was not pumping out a lot of content. He was not pumping out a lot of movies. I knew that if you get a big corporation involved, there's going to be all kinds of issues. And this is just one of them, one of many. Where it all ends up, I don't know. I think Mandalorian could possibly be in jeopardy. Probably not. Most of season 3 has probably been scripted, and Jon Favreau is probably going to have to do some rewrites. So that might cause some problems. It's already rumored that Jon Favreau's not very happy with having to do that. understandably. And then, of course, George Lucas is also not happy with how things were handled. So that's kind of what's going on in the news with Star Wars. The other thing I was going to bring up, I think it was under maybe the Bleeding Fool website. There is a proposed, potentially DC might be bought out, number of high-level rolling DC comic fans are putting together a pitch to take over the publishing of DC Comics into perpetuity, while Warner Brothers retains the movie, TV, gaming, and merchant rights. I don't think this would be a good investment. I mean, first of all, the money is in the merchandising rights. It's not in the comic books. The margins of sales, the margins of revenue in producing comic books, paper comic books, is pretty low. I don't think it's that great. I don't think it ever has been that great. Maybe back in the era when nothing was digital, everything was paper. It was maybe a different story back then, but these days, most comic book publishers, they make money, a lot of them, but I don't think they make a ton of money. So, there's rumors of people, I guess they're valuing it somewhere between $300 million to maybe $500 million in value. AT&T would probably like to get out of the physical comic book publishing business. There's been rumors of people like maybe Robert Kirkman. He's got a lot of money from The Walking Dead, obviously. He's pretty well, yeah, I'd say him and McFarlane are probably some of the wealthiest guys in the comic book business that are, sort of independent. I don't think Marvel is interested in buying, or rather Disney. I don't think Disney's really interested in buying a DC. So maybe there'll be some kind of hedge fund put together. The article makes the comment that it's likely to be multiple parties would be involved. You probably wouldn't see one individual or one company buyout. It might be a group. It seems possible. I know the head of Diamond, Giuseppe, whatever his name is, Giuseppe, I think his name is. Is it Giuseppe? He sounds like an Italian toy maker. I think he's got a lot of money as well. He may be interested in purchasing. I don't know. It's interesting. DC's obviously got problems. They've had problems. Last year, they got rid of a lot of people. A lot of high-end people were fired. The editor, Dan Didio, was fired. And it's sort of been struggling ever since. I think without Batman, I don't know that DC would have any relevance at all. Superman has not been selling very well for many years. Bendis did not do anything to help sales of Superman at all. Batman has been really, pretty well since Tynion took over. That's been a shining light with DC, but that's about it. I mean, I struggle to think of comic books that are selling well at DC other than Batman. There really isn't. So what are you going to do? That's it. It's sort of a problem. So who knows? Maybe somebody will buy out DC. Maybe Warner Brothers /AT&T will want to sell it. That could be big news this year in 2021. Remains to be seen, though. Obviously, we don't know. There is not a lot. There are solicitations here listed for the month of May. Not a lot, though. So you got Heroes Reborn. I don't know why they're didn't they already do this once, the Heroes Reborn thing? That was back in the mid-2000s, if I don't know. It comes to my mind that it was in the mid-2000s. But Jason Aaron is taking the helm here in the writing. Ed McGuinness is doing the art. Looks like Dale Keown is going to be helping him. Cover art by Linnell Francis Yu. I don't know. This is maybe a mini-series run, it looks like. They are showing the first four issues, so maybe this is going to be a weekly ran book for a while. I don't, who knows? But they're showing the first four issues already. The other thing I thought that looked interesting was a new Boba Fett series by Charles Soule and Steve McNiven. I love McNiven's art. That's a cool cover. Oops. I like that cover. Very nice. I'm sure there's going to be more than one cover, but that is the initial cover of the A cover. Boba Fett, Nowhere to Hide. That's the only teaser we get so far. X-Men number 20. Hickman, again, writing, and Francesco Mobili. I don't know how to pronounce that. That looks interesting. Cover of Nimrod there. I don't know. X-Men books have just not, they've not kept my attention. So, Amazing Spider-Man, King Giant Sized. Again, Spencer's not exactly my favorite writer. I wish they would put a better writer on Spider-Man. I think it would do much better. X-Corp number one. You get another reboot of an X-book. Another reboot of Defenders number one. Al Ewing doing the writing. Guardians of the Galaxy number 14. Nice cover by Brett Booth. I like that. Looks like that will be... I think they started a new storyline in issue 13. So 13 might be a key issue. 14 also could be a key issue. What else we got? There's not a lot here. Again, more of these Reborn tie-ins. Looks like they're revamping Squadron, Young Squadron, Hyperion, yeah. Fantastic Four Life Story, kind of like what they did with Spider-Man Life Story. Of course, I liked the Spider-Man Life Story because it had Chip Zdarsky writing. This is written by Mark Russell. I have no idea if that will be any good. X-Men Curse of the Man-Thing. I like Daniel Acuña's art, so that could be worth grabbing. And that's about it. So that's all they're showing so far for Marvel solicitations. Rest are all trades. I believe there's a few DC solicitations as well. Let me see here. Where is that? Hold on, guys. Yeah. So here is the solicitations for May for DC. Mr. Miracle, The Source of Freedom. I like that cover. It's pretty cool. Kind of like that. Brandon Easton. Art by Fico Asio. Kind of like a Mr. Miracle book, as long as it's not written by Tom King. We'll see if it's any good. Wonder Girl number one. Looks like a cool cover by Joelle Jones. She's going to be doing the writing and the art. B cover by Grandpa. Saying cardstock minimum order of 250 copies. That's interesting. I don't know what that means. A retailer has to order 250 copies. Future State Gotham. Is that Nightwing? Not Nightwing. Who is that? New character, maybe? Ooh, man, that James Stokey cover looks awesome. That is some nice detail. I like that James Stokey cover. Very nice. Regular covers by Pewtree. Yeah, I like that Stokey cover. Might have to get that for the cover. Let's see what else we got here from DC. Legends of the Dark Knight number one. Several different covers. Little Federici cover. That looks like Mr. Freeze. yeah. It could be, you know, again, anything Batman's gonna do well. I'd say most of the non-Batman books within DC are not gonna sell that well. Maybe the first issue that it'll get decent sales, but after that, I think you'll see a big drop off. Yeah, Stargirl's not gonna sell. Don't even bother. Even Justice League doesn't do that well. As well as it should. You know, it should do a lot better, but it doesn't. What else we got here? DC Hope at World's End. That looks like a one-shot. Tom Taylor. That's a nice Matina cover. Gotta love those Matina covers. Oh, yeah. I'm Not Starfire. This is DC's attempt to reach young readers. You can see here that is Starfire's short, fat, goth child. Pretty sure she wouldn't pass any genetic coding onto that. But so yeah, there's a lot of memes out there that the father might be the Penguin. She looks more like the Penguin. Yeah, you know, this is appealing to young teens. I don't think there's a lot of people that are going to identify with this. But it might do well in sales just because of how much the book has been ridiculed by, you know, other YouTubers. I've watched a lot of channels that have dug in pretty heavily into this. I just think it's kind of funny. You know, hey, maybe they'll have decent sales because the controversy it created. Who knows? That's another way to do it. Superman Action Comics. I'm glad that Bendis is off of it. Maybe it'll start to be good again. I do like that Tedesco B cover. It's pretty nice. Tedesco reminds me of a Norman Rockwell. Very similar to a Norman Rockwell type of art. I love that type of art. Regular Superman number 31. Again, Philip Kennedy Johnson is doing the writing scripts. The A cover looks pretty nice by John Timms. And then there will also be an N-Hook Lee variant cover. So maybe Superman can be relevant again. I didn't care for Bendis' run. I tried it. I gave it a try. And it didn't work out. So maybe it's going to be worth buying again. I don't know. We'll see. Batman number 108. You've got the new character here. Miracle Molly. Everyone's going to be ordering pretty heavily on this book. Don't go crazy. I mean, I would definitely pick up the A and B cover. B cover's pretty nice. Is that Derek Chu cover? Looks like Derek Chu. Oh, Archerm. Okay, yeah. Archerm cover. There's also a Federici cover that looks pretty awesome. A 1 in 25. Pretty sure that's going to do fairly well. So, you know, normally, if you're only going to buy one, buy the A cover. She's on the cover. So, first cover appearance will be considered the A cover for the most part. Of course, the Archerm cover looks pretty nice as well. And of course, the 1 in 25 will be the incentive cover that a lot of people may. I could see a lot of shops jacking this up. First appearance of a character, yeah, you're going to have a hard time buying this for ratio. So, you know, this is probably a really solid flip opportunity on this Federici variant. If you can pick it up for $25, I'm pretty certain that's going to be selling for over 50 by the time of release, probably more like $75 at time of release. So if you want this book, I would hunt down the pre-order on this really quick. Find a website that sells it, you know, that sells this ahead of time, and get your order in early, because the price is only going to go higher, in my opinion, on that book. Batman Black and White, number 6. A little cool cover there. What is that? Is that John Romita? Oh, I can't stand John Romita. I take that back. John Romita and Klaus Jan. Yeah, I won't pick up the A cover. I don't like John Romita. B cover is by Jason Fabok. Fabok's pretty solid. That's a good cover. And the C cover is by Yasmin Putri. I got to say, I like the B cover the best. I think that's the one I would go with. I like that one. I'll probably just pick that one up, the B cover. Batman Detective. No more, looks like no more Bermejo covers. He'd been doing the B cover, variant covers for quite some time. Looks like in 1000, oh, I'm sorry. This is a miniseries. Batman the Detective number 2. Sorry about that. So, Tom Taylor writing, Kubert art. Yeah, scratch that. Had nothing to do with Detective Comics. Tom King book. I don't care for Tom King. We're going to skip over that. Scooby-Doo, we'll skip that. Superman, Batman. B cover looks interesting. Oh, yeah. Simon Bianchi. Very cool. I like that. That's a kind of a gritty looking cover there. We got, what is this next one here? Batman Urban Legends. Chip Zdarsky. I think it's worth picking it up for Zdarsky. His writing is awesome. I don't like that cover. That is a John Romita. B cover. Who did that B cover? David Marquez. And the A cover. Who did the A cover? Oh. Yeah, it says variant cover by Simon Bianchi. I don't know. Is that the? I think they got this mixed up. So that, I think that's Simon. That's pretty sure that's Simon Bianchi's work. Bianchi, however you pronounce it. So I kind of like the Bianchi cover there best. Catwoman 31, nice Frizen cover. I love that. I'm a big buyer of Frizen covers. I'll be putting that in my pre-order list. Super Sons number 2. You never know, there could be something going on in that book. You know, sometimes you'll get a new appearance of somebody. That one may be worth looking at. Crime Syndicate. David Finch cover. Yeah, it's a nice Finch cover. A lot of detail in that. Variant cover by Babs Tarr. I like that name, Babs. My name's not Barbara, it's Babs. It's a cool cover, I like it. There we go, Batman Detective Comics, number 1036. There's the Bermejo cover, oh yeah. I mean, I'll just buy, I mean, the writing on it has been good. Detective has been solid. And Bermejo cover, yeah, that's, it's a beautiful piece of art. No doubt I'll be pre-ordering that. Flash 770. Not been reading Flash. Not been reading Green Lantern. Been skipping all that. Harley Quinn. Joker. I've been picking up Joker. So we got Joker number 3. A cover is interesting. B cover is a card cover. Looks like Fabok art. Let's see if I'm right about that. Oh, I did the cover. Of course, there's the Federici cover, James Gordon. I mean, he can draw. Federici knows how to draw. There's no doubt about that. Gary Frank. That's the Gary Frank cover. That's totally Gary Frank. I like that. I like the Gary Frank cover. It's probably the one I'd go with. Finch. So the card cover's by Finch. Who did the A cover? I can't tell who that is. Oh, Gilliam March. Yeah, okay, Gilliam March did the A cover. So of the covers, I like the Gary Frank cover the best. That's the one I would grab. The Gordon cover will be a 1 in 25. I'll probably skip on that. Justice League 61. Ooh, I like that B cover. That's pretty nice. That's by, oh, of course, Kale No. Of course. I love Kale No's art. Yeah, I like that cover. So we've got, who's in here in this story? We got Ragman, Zatanna, Constantine. Uh-oh, it's written by Bendis. Oh, boy. I tend to not want to get things by Bendis, but that cover makes me want to buy that, so I might end up getting that just for the cover art. Man-Bat versus Batman, number 4. Next Batman, Second Son, number 2. It's a nice Matina cover. Hard to say no to those Matina covers. Man, that's pretty nice. Nightwing. Again, Batman does the best. The rest of them, not so much. Robin, number 2. I definitely recommend getting the Robin series. I know there's a first appearance in that first issue. There probably could be another new appearance. I would just pick it up. I would, at least the first 5 issues of Robin, I would pick up. Art by Gleb. And there's a variant cover by Manipul. That's pretty nice. I like that variant cover. I think getting both covers makes sense on that issue. Sensational Wonder Woman. Variant cover by Marguerite Savage. Not sure about that. Suicide Squad variant cardstock cover by Perel. Has Red X on it. I could see that being a hot book. Not his first cover appearance. That's the second printing. Well, it depends on what you're talking about, right? Technically, he was in Teen Titans Go a couple years ago. But I could see this cover being hot. A lot of people will go for that cover, I'm pretty sure. Teen Titans Academy, number 3. I like that cover by Philip Tan. That's pretty good. Very nice. Superman Red and Blue. That's a weird picture of Superman right there. Who did that? John Paul Leon. I'm pretty sure that's John Paul Leon. I could tell his artwork anywhere. So that's John Paul Leon. A cover. That looks... Who is that by? A cover. I'm not too sure. Paul Pope, maybe Paul Pope. But I like that cover by Leon. That's definitely Leon artwork there. Swamp Thing number 3. Well, that A cover is pretty nice. A lot of detail on that cover. Poison Ivy. Of course, the B cover by Kyle Holtz is pretty nice too. A lot of detail on that as well. Holy crap, that's a nice cover. Mike Perkins did the A cover. Yeah, they're both nice covers on Swamp Thing number 3. What else are we going to look at here? Wonder Woman 772. Ooh, man, look at that Middleton cover. Oh, I like that. That's going to be a hot cover. Yeah, I'm going to have to get that one. I love Middleton's artwork, and that is a great, great piece of art by him. Fantastic. I love it. And I think that's it. Rest is old trades. All right, guys. That's kind of what I had to talk about. Just a few things to look at in the world of comic books. Nothing too dramatic. If you haven't already, please subscribe to my channel. Hit the bell for notifications. Leave a comment. Let me know what you think. I will have a new video out tomorrow for a new comic book day. So catch that in the afternoon. Hope everyone has a great evening, and I'll see you tomorrow.